Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to Anime King. And today I'm going to be giving you part 16 of What If Naruto Had Multiple People Sealed Inside of Him. Remember to get this one to 100 likes as usual, share this to all of your friends on your social media platform, and also stay in tune because after this I'm going to be posting a new episode of What If Naruto Took His Training Seriously. So stay in tune for that, and I hope you guys enjoy. And later on over on Anime King 2, I'm going to be posting a new episode of Naruto Ancestor. And also, what if Naruto was trained by gods? So stay in tune for that, and I hope you guys enjoy each and every episode. And remember, if you're new and this is the first time hearing my voice, and you enjoy the videos on Anime King and Anime King 2, click that red subscribe button and become a part of the Anime King family. And thank you for all of your help and your support, guys. And yeah, without further ado, let's get straight into this new episode. Start the intro. So, the last time we left off, Naruto told Kin about Teowaya. He know all about her, so he's gonna save Kin as he wants her to become a part of the Fuhen clan. And Kin greatly accepted, as she was grateful to get rid of Orochimaru, as she wanted Teowaya to be a part of the clan as well, and Naruto assured her that Teowaya will. They then went into the preliminaries, as the main matches were Hinata versus Kiba. Seeing that Hinata now has her Prachio card and her Byakugan has evolved, Kiba was no match for her as she beat him down. As Hayashi was confused, how was there another level of the Byakugan and how did she possess it after he kicked her out of the clan? Now he has to find a way to get her back or get rid of her. Naruto then faced off against Neji as he beat the absolute crap out of Neji for the way he used to treat Hinata. As Sakura think that she could beat Ino, Ino revealed that she's far stronger as Ino beat Sakura to a pulp. And for the finals, we have Eva versus Haku. Match 2 will be Konkuro versus Shino. Match 3 will be Ino versus Hinata. Match 4 will be Temari versus Shikamaru. Match 5 will be Oshaisu versus Gaara. And match 6 will be Lee versus Naruto, and the winner of match 6 will face off against Sasuke. With that, the preliminaries are over, as they all were teleported to the Fuhen compound, as Shaymo was the one who brought them there, as they reveal some information about Baki, the Sand Siblings Sensei, that he went on mission with Young, Chunin and even Genin girls, and they always end up missing, as he wanted to force himself on Temari and gain some political stance in the Sand Village. But Temari said her father will never go for that, as he would make sure to execute him. But Sarutobi then told them that the Kazekage is dead. Yeah guys, that was basically the last part we left off. You guys can just across the place and check it over yourself. So, let's start this new episode. As Temari and Konkuro were shocked, as Naruto spoke, he has been dead since a week before you left the Sand. Orochimaru killed him, and those bodyguards are even imposter, Naruto said. All except for Baki. He got an offer from the snake and he took it, as he wanted the reward. Are you sure? How do you know all these things anyway? Konkuro asks, shocked. Like I told Kin earlier, there is more to Orochimaru's seal than even he know. To put it simply, I cracked the seal that he placed on the Uchiha and I got Orochimaru's memory. So, all of that thing you say are true? Gaara asks. Yes, said Naruto. Then no one will complain if I do this, said Gaara, as Baki then screamed out in pain as his legs were crushed completely by the Sand. Why didn't you kill him? You normally kill people for looking at you funny, Konkuro said, confused. Am I that worthless to him? Temari thought, thinking that her brother didn't really care about her. to kill Baki. No, Temari. He just wants to get as much information before they kill him, said Nadoka, reading Temari's thoughts. Gaara, please let him go so we can take him somewhere else for the interrogation. Don't forget your visit, said Nadoka. As Gaara released him, as Anko wrapped him around with snakes and pulled him away to the dungeon, as Nadoka followed behind her. Let's go inside and talk things over dinner, Naruto said. Sure, as everyone went inside. Sometime later, all of them sit at the table as the Raikage spoke. If you don't mind me asking, why was Gaara following information from a rat? Said the Raikage. I am not a rat. I am a hermit, said Shamus. I was approached yesterday by Naruto and Shamo with a very tempting offer, Gaara explained. And what might that be? The Raikage asked. He gave me an offer I couldn't refuse. And if he fulfilled his end of the bargain, I wouldn't even have to go back to the sand, Gaara said. Huh? Said Temari as she looked at Naruto. Replacing or fix his seal so he can sleep without fear of losing his mind, said Naruto. You said that you were good with seals, but I didn't know that you were that good, said Yujito. Run in the family, said Naruto with a shrug. You mean you can seal Shikaku away for good? Konkuro asked, hopefully. First of all, I need to understand all this Shikaku business, Naruto said. The Bijus don't have and absolutely refuse to take on human name. It's a matter of pride. So, his real name is the Ichibai. No Tonuki, not Shikaku, Naruto said. But he has been calling himself Shikaku since I know him, said Gaara. Well, we'll have to see what that's about. And by the way, it's not a boy, it's a she. What? The three sand ninja yell. The Kyuubi and the Nibis are girl as well, Yujito informed them. Like I told Gaara earlier, the reason he doesn't know much about his tenant is the defective seal, Naruto said. When was the last time your seal was checked? Asked Sarutobi. Check, said Gaara confused. Oh boy, said the Raikage. Please tell me that someone check if the seal is working properly. At least once a year, Naruto asked as he looked at all of them. As far as I know, the last time was before the assassination attempts started, said Temari. Makes sense. The longer you stay with a defective seal, the more insane you got, Eva told Gaara. You dare call me insane, said Gaara. As sand came from his gourd and went over to Eva, but it then turned into ice and shattered on the ground. I dare because I can. You're insane, said Eva as she sighed in annoyance. If you weren't, you would have never tried to attack me a while ago. Well, you can blame that on the lousy connection you have with the Ichibai, she said. And that's what we're here to fix, Naruto said. Are you sure you can do it though? Konkuro asked, doubtfully. Tell me, Gaara, is your seal more complicated than this? Naruto said, as he lifted up his shirt and showed Gaara his seal. No, not even close, said Gaara, as he looked at Naruto's seal. Well, this is exactly what I'm going to place on you to replace the old one. Hold on. Replace? Said Sarutobi. Yeah, that's what I said, old man, Naruto said that grin, knowing where this was going. You do realize in order to replace a seal, you must remove the old one, right? Said Sarutobi nervously. Relax, old man. I will talk with the Ichibai first and ask her why she's making Gaara go crazy and convince her to remain in Gaara's body while I work on the seal, Naruto explained. And how exactly would you convince a demon to remain in captivity? The Raikage asks. By offering her freedom, said Naruto. Are you out of your mind? Sarutobi, A, Samui, and Temari said, while Konkuro and Gaara and Yujito just looked at him confusedly. It would be nice to be by myself and I could sleep carefree. But if it is extracted, wouldn't that result in my death? Gaara asked, raising the eyebrow. You see, said Naruto, when a Biju is sealed, their physical body is either destroyed or absorbed by the spiritual process. Therefore, unless they are transported to another host, the Biju's body tries to take control over their host's body. So, you're going to give the Ichibai her own body, Temari asks. Yes, and Gaara will still keep the amount of yokai he has right now, Naruto explained. How? If you remove the Bijuu, its power will go along with it, said Sarutobi. The seal I'm going to put on Gaara right now will take some of Ichiba's chakra, and it will be there for a supplement. So it will seem like Gaara would still have Ichiba inside of him. Even if he uses up amount of the yokai, it would reform and he can still use more, Naruto explained. Ask him now, said the Nibi. I see. Will you be doing the same for the Nibi? Asked Yujito. Of course, Naruto said. I know this will sound like a stupid question, but what will happen to them once they have their own bodies? Kankuro asks. Well, that's not a stupid question. What will happen to them? Temari asks. Well, they have three options, Naruto said. They can wander around the elemental countries like the Kyuubi did and risk getting caught again. They can leave the elemental countries and try to survive in those unknown lands. Or they can stay here in Konoha and join my clan. Don't you have enough women? Kankuro asks with a perverted smirk. I didn't mean that, you pervert, Naruto said as he looked at Kankuro. But considering how handsome I am, they would want to join my clan, Naruto said. Proud of your looks, I see, said Negi. Well, considering that I don't know them and they don't know me. So, we will have to talk, said Naruto. I see, said Gaara thoughtfully. What would I gain besides a clear mind and a reserve of yokai, Gaara asks. You will have complete control over your yokai. It would be your power, not a borrowed one, Naruto said. Will its ultimate defense still work, Temari asks. Most likely. Since his sand is fused with his chakra, it acts like a third arm. It is connected with you, said Naruto. When do we do this? Gaara asks. When your mind is stable enough. That means I need to speak with the Ichibai. And that involves me entering your mindscape, Naruto said. Are you sure you can handle that? No offense, Gaara, but I doubt that the inside of your head will be pretty with all that you went through, Temari said. Come on, it can't be that bad, right? Said Sarutobi. Well, I will go ahead and enter your mind right now, if you want me to. Just remember to allow me total control, Naruto said. Why? Gaara asks. As an outsider, I would have no control over your mindscape. And without any power, I can get seriously hurt inside. Very well. Go ahead, said Gaara as he closed his eyes. Naruto then went through one-handed hand sign as his hand became transparent as he put his hand right through Gaara's forehead as he stopped at the wrist. As Naruto then closed his eyes as well, as they felt like electricity run through the both of them. As Naruto opened back his eyes as both him and Gaara were in the mindscape. As Naruto looked around, it looked like a desert and there were many tornadoes around ready to kill them. Gaara, I need control and I need it now, Naruto said as the tornadoes were coming towards him. Go ahead, said Gaara. Naruto then closed his eyes as all the tornadoes then vanished. As the sand settled down, the both of them got a good look at the mindscape. Wow, Gaara, your head is empty, Naruto said, with a chuckle, as he then found himself in a sand cocoon. Please remind me why I should let you live, Gaara said. Well, you want to sleep and be able to think straight, Naruto said. Then let's get this over with. This place reminds me of a nightmare I had when I sleep once, Gaara muttered. Yeah, nightmares, Naruto said with a frown, as he remembered some of his own. As Gaara placed down Naruto, as they saw the sand behind them start to rise, as they saw two golden shuriken eyes as the Shikaku took form. You must be the Ichibai. I'm your new neighbor. My name is Naruto. Nice to meet ya, Naruto said as Gaara was looking between Naruto and the Ichibai in shock. Foolish mortal. I am Shikaku, the most powerful being in the world. How dare you enter my vessel? You shall pay for this, the monster said as he roared as sand started to cover Naruto's body. Wrong answer, said Naruto as he blew away the sand off of him as sand around Shikaku's legs turned into lava as it then hardened and stuck him in one spot. You dare attack me? Gaara, kill him now. Let me feed on his blood, said Shikaku. Gaara, you have no reason to listen to this leech, Naruto said. As Shikaku froze when he heard that. Have I struck a nerve? Said Naruto with a smirk. Shikaku, or rather, Shikaku Sabirama, the first Jinjuriki of Ichibai, Naruto said with an evil smirk. How? It's been over 100 years. How can a mere mortal like you know about me? Shikaku asked in surprise. Have you not listened to mine and Gaara's conversation? Naruto asked. I have better things to do than listening to what my vessels speak to, said Shikaku. Then allow me to introduce myself. My name is Naruto Fuhen, container of the Nine-Tailed Kyuubi. You're her container? Said Shikaku in shock. Yeah, and I'm also here to set the Ichibai free. Naruto then activated his eternal Mangekyo Sharingan. Looks like I was right, you're just a parasite on the Ichibai soul. The only thing that belongs to you are those markings all over her body. How can you know so much with a mere look? The Shikaku asks as he tried to back away, but he realized his feet were still stuck. I recognize those eyes. The Sharingan evolved to the Mangekyo. But no Uchiha has ever seen through me like that. Foolish leech, I am not a Uchiha, Naruto said in disgust. And this is no Mangekyo. My eyes are 2 levels above the Mangekyo. This is the Yokai Eternal Mangekyo Sharingan. Never heard of it, said the Shikaku. Yeah, that's right, because I'm the first person to have it, Naruto said. Now, you should feel honored, Shikaku. You're the first one I'm going to show this. My Susanoo, Naruto said. As a large soldier surrounded Naruto's body, he had flowing white hair with yellow slitting eyes. It also had 2 marks on his cheek, similar to the Inuzaka. It wore clothes similar to a samurai, and it had 2 katana at its side. Now, take this, Naruto said, as the warrior pulled one of his katana as it was surrounded by a blue glow. You think I'm going to let you defeat me so easily? Said Shikaku, as the sand around him then picked up, as all of them flew towards Naruto. Naruto swiped the blade as he released a blue energy that destroyed all the sand. As the sword then turned completely blue, as the Susanoo rushed forward as it sliced right through Shikaku. But Shikaku screamed out in pain even though there was no wound. How is this even possible? This body is made up of sand. No physical thing should harm me. What kind of sword is that? This sword is called my Tensega sword, and it attacked the soul, not the body. As a snake then came from the Shikaku's forehead and started to run away, as Naruto then stabbed right through it with the Tensega, killing it. Well, that wasn't so hard, Naruto said, as a Susanoo disappeared in particle of light. You are a very odd person, Fuhen, Gaara stated, as he stared at Naruto in shock. Thanks, I try, Naruto said, as the both of them then walk up to the Ichibai. Wait, where am I? She said. What's going on? As her eyes then widened, where is that damn Shikaku, so I can rip him to pieces? Sorry to disappoint you, miss, but I killed that damn leech, Naruto said. As for where are you, you're sealed in Gaara, over here. Another container? Damn that second Kazekage and that fourth Kazekage. Not only did he seal me inside of that mad priest Shikaku, who transported a piece of his soul to take over my body, and now he sealed me inside of a kid? She then roared as Naruto had to activate chakra to his feet to stick to the ground. Hey, mind taking your human form so we can talk more properly? Said Naruto, as a table appeared with 3 chairs. Fine, she said, as a golden light came from her, as she then shrink to a human size. Is this better? Both Gaara and Naruto stared at her with wide eyes, as they were blushing, as they looked at the woman in front of them. She had a perfect figure like the Kyuubi, with D-cup breasts. She had golden blonde hair, with yellow shuriken eyes, not to mention that she was completely naked. Yeah, that will be nice, said Naruto, as he wiped away a small amount of blood dripping from his nose. You forgot clothes, said Gaara as he looked away. Ah, sorry about that. It's been so long since I wear any, Ichibai said. Allow me, said Naruto. as he snapped his finger and she was dressed in a golden kimono. She created a mirror and looked into it. "Nice," she said. She then took a seat at the table. As Naruto explained to her, "So, I just need you to stay in the seal long enough for me to start the new seal and then I'll build a body for you." "Tempting, very tempting," said Ichibei. "But I kind of doubt that you'll let me run free if I don't want to stay in Konoha or join your clan." "Well, like I said, I need to make a patio with you in order to summon your soul into your new body. The patio allow me to talk to you telepathically, summon you, and even restrain you in some situations. But I honestly doubt that you would blow your cover and attack a hidden village out of boredom," Naruto said. "Fine, but I doubt you will need them. I will stay in Konoha, but I need to do something before you change the seal." And she then turned towards Gaara. "And what would that be?" Gaara asked. "You gain control over sand by having me inside of you, but my main power is pure wind element. I will mess with your chakra nature a bit to increase your wind affinity. It will also increase your sand affinity as well. Consider it a gift for me, making your life hell," said Ichibei as she felt sorry. "It's alright, thank you," Gaara said. Soon after that, Naruto left Gaara's mind so the Ichibei could work in peace. "What happened? The seal glow blue and part of it disappeared. I almost thought that you were trapped in there," said Sarutobi as he approached Naruto. "I'm fine, I just killed the spirit of Shikaku, the first container of the Ichibei. Apparently, he somehow attached his soul to her. By the way, how long have I been out?" Naruto asked. "About half an hour," said Eva. "What happened to Gaara? Why is he still unconscious?" Temari asked as she was starting to get worried. "The Ichibei is increasing his wind affinity. Before I put a new seal on him, it should be easier this way. And he should start screaming right now," Naruto said. As soon as he said that, Gaara was covered in a yellow yokai as he started to scream on top of his lungs as it went on for about 30 seconds until he finally stopped. Time skip. 2 hours later, the sealing process was done as Naruto put on the new seal as Gaara was sleeping comfortably in the bed that they were staying in for the exams. As Temari and Konkuro looked down at Gaara, it was strange to see him sleeping like this, as they were happy for their younger brother. An hour later, Naruto was at the hot springs as he was watching a white-year-old man peeping at the ladies. As he sighed, Sarutobi told him that this man could teach him some of his father's technique, as Naruto didn't know why he come here. "Are you Jiraiya of the Sanid, Arthur of the Ichi Ichi series?" Naruto asked loudly. "Yep, if you want the autograph, come back later. I have some research to do," said Jiraiya. "Oh, so that also means," said Naruto as he cracked his knuckles, "you're my godfather who left me for all these years." At that moment, Jiraiya turned around. As he saw Naruto looking at him, his eyes red and slitted as Naruto was pissed off. Naruto brought his hands together as he was engulfed by a golden glow. As Jiraiya saw the boy vanish, as Jiraiya felt pain in his stomach, as he looked down to see Naruto's hand, as he was blown out of the tree, as he broke through the wooden wall, as he was now in the woman's hot spring, as Naruto then vanished. 2 days later, Naruto, Neji, Eva, and Asuna were heading towards the Hokage's tower. "You want to see us, old man," Naruto said. As the four of them entered the office, as Jiraiya was still in bandages, that punch that Naruto gave him crack a couple of his ribs. "Yes, I want to talk to you," said Sarutobi, as he reactivated the privacy seal and sealed the door closed. As all of them created that cheer for themselves, as none of them wanted to sit beside Jiraiya, they all hated him for leaving Naruto, and Naruto hate him as well. "So, how did it go with Yujito's seal?" said Sarutobi. "Perfect," said Naruto. "You should have asked for my help. I am the most experienced seal master in Konoha after all," said Jiraiya. "So, what else do you want to talk about?" Sarutobi, Naruto asked, completely ignoring Jiraiya. "How are you doing with your other project that you were working on?" Sarutobi asks. "I'm getting there," said Naruto. "Good, good. I am very excited about this new project that you're working on. as I would like to see the final goal, said Sir Toby. So, how's your training for the finals going? Asked Sir Toby. Not bad, we learned a few more techniques, increase our gravity weight. Haku is still working on that new Hayaton Jutsu that affects the enemy blood. But even with the amount of books and scrolls that we have, without a Jonin around to teach us some new tricks, we'll have to think about some new stuff to do with our free time, rather than training. Too bad the council is still forcing the Uchiha to train Sasuke. I was hoping for him to teach me the Chidori, or at least my father Rasengan, Naruto said. I can teach you the Rasengan, Jiraiya offered. Oh well, I guess I can look through some more scrolls. By the way, have you learned anything else on Orochimaru? No, he's laying low for now. You scared him pretty good before the preliminaries. He's probably keeping the invasion a secret, said Sarutobi. Invasion? Said Jiraiya as he got up with a groan. Still, I can't believe what a disappointment he has become, said Sarutobi. Yes, how the mighty have fallen, said Naruto. From the legendary Sanin, your three best student has become one of the legendary pedophile that experiments on everyone. And then we have the legendary sucker who gambled every time and drowned herself in sake. And she can't even look at blood without freezing up, even though she's a medic. And then we have the legendary pervert who, right about smut, drink as much as Tsunade and hasn't been anywhere near Konoha in 13 years. Even though he has a godson here, the son of his beloved student. A godson that spent most of his life getting beaten. Abused for something that wasn't his fault. I guess checking out all the whorehouse in the elemental nations is more important than his godson well-being, Naruto said. He couldn't even check to see if the money that he sent to his godson got to the kid. He thought that the civilian council would stop hating the kid because of that? They will always hate him because he had the Kyuubi. He never even knew that the civilian council took his money that he sent for his own godson to hire assassins to kill him. Or maybe that is the reason why he sent it. Jiraiya then froze when he heard that. Maybe he thought that his godson was actually a demon and he wanted him to die because the demon killed his precious student. No, I'm not blaming you, Naruto, Jiraiya said as he collapsed on the floor as he was crying. I was looking out for you, gathering information on those who were trying to capture the Biju. I didn't know what the civilians were up to, I swear, I'm sorry. I am sorry for not being there for you. You just reminded me so much of your appearance that it was too much to bear. I'm sorry, I'm so sorry. Naruto looked at Jiraiya with the coldest look he can muster. It hurt me even more when I was getting 10 assassinations per week. When I was 4 and my so-called guards watched as I got the crap beaten out of me until I was near death, they stepped in and they said they didn't even see what happened to me. Jiraiya eyes wide in horror when he heard that. It hurt me even more when I was on the streets for 6 months after they kicked me out of the orphanage and the Hokage found me almost dying from lack of water, food, and a dozen kunai sticking out of my back. Now Jiraiya was trembling. It hurt me even more. During October 10th, my birthday, when they hunt me down like an animal and beat me until I nearly died. And it hurt me the most to know that people are out there, like my own godfather, who should have taken care of me or even check up on me. So don't you dare apologize or say that it hurt you, because if it had, you would have been here. They spend the next few minutes, Jiraiya crying his eyes out, begging for forgiveness. While Naruto's being hugged by Eva and Asuna, while Negi was keeping a comforting hand on his shoulder, as Sarutobi was looking at them with regret in his eyes. Listen up, said Naruto after he calmed down. I have everything I wanted right now. Money, power, talent, a home. More importantly, I have friends. Family, girls that love me, and that I love. So, I don't need you. Or anything that you will have to train me in, I can learn it myself. At this, Jiraiya lowered his head in defeat. But I will give you one chance to redeem yourself in my eyes. There will be conditions and rules you will have to obey, lots of them, and I won't budge on any. Are you willing to take that chance, or will you run away again like before? I will take it, no matter what you ask me to do, Jaria said with determination. Very well, I'll get you a list as soon as possible, Narta said with a smirk. Here is the most important rule. Never keep any secret from me. Just because you think you know better, or you're trying to save me in some way. Just never keep a secret from me. It doesn't matter what it is. If I tell you to jump, you're going to ask me which cliff. If I tell you to kill someone, that person better be on brink of death. If I tell you that Kayubi is a goddess, you better to God start worshipping her. Do you understand? Narta asks. Yes, sir, said Jiraiya. Good, now you're treating us to some ramen for lunch, Narta said with a smirk, as Sarutobi realized that Jiraiya is going to go bankrupt. Sure, Jiraiya said a small smile, happy that Naruto was about to give him another chance. And after lunch, you're going to let me, Konoha, Eva, Asuna, and Negi join the Toad Contract, and you're going to teach us how to summon. And if we're done by the end of the day, you're going to teach us the Rasengan. Now, let's move, Naruto said, as he headed to the door, followed by Jiraiya. Oh, and one more thing. Do anything perverted around me or my friends, or anything in my presence or near my girls, and I'll let Uncle and the Kayubi neuter you, Naruto said. At that last comment, Jiraiya paled. Before Naruto could open the door, Danzo opened it for them, as most of the civilian council burst in the office. Sarutobi, what's the meaning of this? Said Danzo. We just saw the recordings of the preliminaries. And this brat, he said, pointing at Naruto, have an evolved Sharingan when talking to that sound Jonin. So, I already knew that, said Sarutobi with a shrug. How? And when did he get it? Asked a civilian. He uses bloodline for absorbing power to drink the blood of a certain Uchiha, said Sarutobi. And as for when, it was the day he demonstrated his other bloodlines. Bloodlines? Jiraiya asked in shock. Later, said Naruto. How dare he take the Sharingan from Sasuke, said an angry civilian. It wasn't Sasuke's blood he used, it was Itachi, before the massacre. And also, it was done in front of several high-ranking ninja and the Shinobi Council, said Sarutobi. But still, said Danzo. But he then stopped as he noticed that Jiraiya and the kids were all gone. At that moment, Naruto was at his 10th bowl of ramen as Jiraiya was looking at his wallet. This kid is going to leave me broke, he thought. But guys, I'm ending this episode right here. If you want to see the next part of this, you already know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and turn on that bell notification to stay posted. Remember to share all of your friends and social media platform, and stay in tune for the rest of the what is coming your way. And I hope you enjoy each and every one of them, guys. And remember, if you're new, to go ahead and click that red subscribe button and join Anime King and Anime King 2 and become a part of the Anime King family. And stay in tune for what if Naruto took his training seriously. And over on Anime King 2, I'm going to be doing a new episode of Naruto Ancestor and also what if Naruto was trained by gods. So stay in tune for that, and I hope you enjoy each and every one of these episodes. And thank you for all of your help and your support. But for now, guys, I'm out of here. Peace. See you later.